Every day, the scientists at the Volcanological and Seismological Observatory of Martinique remain vigilant. On the flanks of Mount Pele, the sensors provide unequivocal evidence. The occurrence of earthquakes is steadily increasing, more than 120 years since its last eruption. Is Mount Pele stirring from its slumber?
The volcanic activity is on the rise. From the 1980s to 2019, we typically observed 2 volcanic earthquakes per month. However, since early 2019, the frequency of volcanic tectonic earthquakes has increased to around 30.
These earthquakes' intensities are not yet noticeable to the population. However, this doesn't prevent the authorities from treating them with utmost seriousness.
The volcano has shown heightened seismic activity, suggesting a shift in its behavior. As a result, since late 2020, authorities have raised the alert level for Mount Pele to yellow.
The yellow alert status clearly indicates that an eruption is likely. The question remains as to when it will occur.
This volcano has witnessed numerous explosive eruptions over the centuries. It is undoubtedly the most dangerous volcano in France.
In Saint-Pierre, no one has forgotten the eruption of May 8, 1902. It remains one of the greatest tragedies of the 20th century, a haunting reminder etched into the daily lives of its inhabitants. However, there were many warning signs leading up to the disaster on May 8, 1902.
The eruptive phase kicks off in February when the scent of sulfur permeated Saint-Pierre. Inside homes, silverware darkened in their cases, which was a bit concerning.
In the weeks leading up to the catastrophe, there were instances of minor eruptions, primarily consisting of water vapor. These eruptions are known as phreatic eruptions.
The magma reservoir, located around 5 to 6 miles deep, started to stir. This upward movement of magma led to the heating of the groundwater, causing it to vaporize. The pressurization and rapid release of these vaporized groundwater resulted in explosions. Therefore, a sequence of explosions took place from April 23rd until May 8th.
In Saint-Pierre, just 3 miles away from the volcano, darkness fell upon the city. Despite this, the population did not evacuate. A few decades prior, similar phreatic explosions had occurred and did not cause any significant damage. However, this time, a completely different and catastrophic scenario begins to unfold, one that the residents of Saint-Pierre could never have anticipated.
On May 8, 1902, at 8:02 a.m., the mountain erupted, changing everything. What actually happened was that magma had been building up at the summit of the volcano, and then there was a sudden lateral explosion.
Inside the volcano, the magma deviated from its usual path of upward escape through the chimney and rushed into a lateral fissure. It is through this fissure, located to the southwest of the crater, that the gases which triggered the explosion emerged.
A lateral explosion carries a higher level of danger compared to a vertical plenian eruption, as all the energy is focused in one direction.
The explosion unleashed a chaotic torrent of ash, debris, and gases, hurtling at a speed of 300 miles per hour and reaching temperatures of 480 degrees Fahrenheit. It charged eastward, swept through the White River Valley towards Saint-Pierre, obliterating a triangular zone spanning 22 square miles.
It's an apocalyptic scene in the blink of an eye. It took only a few minutes for this cascade of fiery and glowing materials to reach the coastal areas.
With tremendous force, this surge of high-speed volcanic materials generated an atmospheric shockwave.
The shockwave struck a few seconds before the arrival of the expelled materials. Research has indicated that the internal organs of the human body were unable to withstand the impact of the shockwave. Many residents were fatally struck by the explosion itself.
It's like the city has been struck by an atomic bomb.
It's a horrifying sight. Dead bodies cover the city. the heat was so intense that it caused glass and bottles to melt.
You could think that the eruption came to a halt at the coastline, but that was not the case. In fact, these pyroclastic flows have the ability to continue their journey, almost like surfing on the water. And that's exactly what occurred over several hundred meters, resulting in the rapid sinking of the few ships moored in St. Pierre's Harbor.
The eruption claimed the lives of 28,000 people, making it the most devastating volcanic event of the 20th century.
Within a span of just 2 minutes, the eruption wiped out Saint-Pierre, obliterating more than one-tenth of the population of Martinique at that time, which was approximately 200,000 people. Only two individuals survived the disaster: a prisoner shielded by the sturdy walls of this cell, and a shoemaker who happened to be in the depths of his basement when the eruption occurred.
Following the events of May 8, 1902, Mount Pele continued to release pyroclastic flows, although they decreased in intensity over time. This might have led some to believe that the eruption was calming down. However, on August 30, a larger pyroclastic flow, potentially twice the size of the initial one, was unleashed. With a significantly broader reach, as it encompassed not just Saint-Pierre, but also the town of Morne Rouge, causing destruction and resulting in the tragic loss of 1,500 lives.
This tragedy stands as one of the deadliest in modern history, holding the unfortunate distinction of having the highest number of fatalities solely attributed to a volcanic event.
Volcanoes can persist for hundreds of thousands of years. Mount Pele is 300,000 years old and may remain active for another 100,000 years or longer.
So the goal is to learn from the past, monitor the present, and be prepared to react quickly when it happens again. Because it's inevitable, it will happen again.